sisters, and welcome back to another episode of What Hadith Am I Reading Today? JazakAllahu khair for clicking on this video. I'm so glad that you're able to join me today for this episode. Now, what am I going to be reading to you today? Well, what I'm going to be reading to you is from Sahih Bukhari. Now, this particular hadith goes over the expiation of sins. And the hadith I'm going to cover from Sahih al-Bukhari is from volume 3, book 30, the Book of As-Saum or Fasting, chapter 3. As-Saum is an expiation for sins, and it's from hadith number 1895. So let's see what this hadith says. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Narrated Abu Wa'il from Hudhayfa, Umar radiallahu anhu asked the people, "Who remembers the narration of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam about the fitna or trial or affliction?" Hudhayfa said, "I heard the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam saying, the fitna of a person in his property, family, and neighbors is expiated by his salat, saum, and giving in charity." So by prayer, fasting, and charity. Umar said, "I do not ask about that, but I ask about the fitna which will spread like the waves of the sea." Hudhayfa replied, "There is a closed gate in front of it." Umar asked, "Will that gate be open or broken?" He replied, "It will be broken." Umar said, "Then the gate will not be closed again till the day of resurrection." We said to Masruq, "Would you ask Hudhayfa whether Umar knew what that gate symbolized?" He asked him and he replied, "He," which is Umar, "knew it as one knows that there will be night before tomorrow morning." So, let's talk a little bit about that hadith and what I feel or what I think it's about. Now, first of all, what is fitna? Fitna is a trial, a temptation. It's sedition, discord, or civil strife. What is expiate? Expiate, or expiation, is to atone for one's sins. In this hadith, Hudhayfa radiallahu anhu says he heard the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam say, "The fitna of a person in his property, family, and neighbors is expiated by his salat, saum, and giving in charity." So, basically, if we were to take from it, what I take from it, first of all, causing fitna or civil strife, or simply put it, trouble amongst others is wrong. And unfortunately, it is something that does happen all too much in our ummah and outside of our ummah as well. Now, it's a sin, and to atone for this sin, any sin, I would think for that matter, is to pray, to fast, and to give in charity. Now, fasting, as this hadith is from the Book of Fasting, is a way to purify ourselves. It's a way to purify our hearts and our intentions. Now, it's also a way to think and reflect upon wrongs we have done or caused to others and seek forgiveness from Allah, and inshallah seek forgiveness from those we have wronged as well. Now, our goal is to lead a righteous life, and through that, help each other and lead each other to Jannah, to paradise. That is our ultimate and final goal, right? So as far as how long one should fast, I really couldn't answer that question for you. And for a question like that, and let me tell you, I'm in no way a scholar. I am just a student of knowledge just like you are. So if you want to find out how long one should fast to expiate for their sins, you may want to go ahead and speak with, you know, a sheikh, an imam, a scholar of knowledge, because they may be able to provide that answer to you and some references as to why that is the case. Now, here's a verse from the Quran that I found. And this is from Quran 3, chapter 3, ayah 135. And those who have done something to be ashamed of or wronged their own souls, earnestly bring Allah to mind and ask for forgiveness for their sins. And who can forgive sins except Allah? And are never obstinate and persisting knowingly in the wrong they have done. I hope this video has been very helpful to you. If it has, definitely give this video a thumbs up. If it hasn't, I certainly do apologize that it was not of benefit to you and that was a fault on my own and not on you. Don't forget to give this video a thumbs up if it was a benefit. Don't forget to leave a comment below. Share this video with other sisters in our Ummah. And if you're watching this and you have not yet subscribed, hit that subscribe button. That way you'll be notified when the next episode goes up, inshallah. Until next time, JazakAllahu khair for watching, subscribing. Assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.